This is Duane Friend with University of Illinois Extension. Normally, air temperatures get cooler the higher you go. However, there are times when air at higher elevations is actually warmer than the air below it. This creates what is called a temperature inversion. The atmosphere is mostly heated from the Earth's surface. Sunlight, in the form of short wavelengths of energy, travels through the atmosphere and is absorbed by the Earth's surface. The energy is then emitted back into the atmosphere, but at longer wavelengths of energy. The atmosphere is heated from these longer wavelengths. The farther from the heat source, which is the Earth's surface, the cooler it gets. On calm and clear nights, the Earth's surface can cool very quickly as it loses heat or radiation, cooling the air right above it. At higher elevations, the air doesn't cool as quickly, so this air becomes warmer than the air below it. A temperature inversion occurs when this happens and is called a radiation inversion. Fog may also form if the cooled air is moist. On coasts, a cool ocean breeze can bring cool air onto land. This creates an advection inversion and is very common along much of the California coast. Because the air doesn't mix with other air, pollutants can build up when an advection inversion is present. Sometimes air high in the atmosphere starts to sink. As it sinks, it begins to warm due to the air being squeezed or compressed from the higher air pressure at lower elevations. The sinking air can warm to the point it is warmer than the air below it, even hundreds or thousands of feet above the Earth's surface. Called an upper air inversion, it acts as a barrier to keep thunderstorms from forming. Most inversions last only a few hours, although some may last for days. When this happens, it can cause very poor air quality as pollutants can build up.